Thank you. I'll keep you long. I just think it's very important. I've always felt, as a Jew myself, that Israel purports to speak in our name, purports to somehow give us a home and provide us protection. And also, Israel always says that any criticism of Israel is anti-Semitism. Well, whatever else I am, I cannot be an anti-Semite. Criticism of Israel is criticism of Israel. It's a disgrace. I want to one day be proud of my country. I want to, well, of that country. I want to be proud one day of my people. At the moment, I am ashamed. But if only Israel, if only Jewish people could turn away from violence, what an amazing thing that would be. And I hope that one day we will. If with our history of oppression, can't do it, who can? I just think I'm so ashamed at the moment. Israel does not act in my name. The only time it will act in my name is when it brings peace to the Middle East. Thank you.
Thank you very much. A few days after Christmas, I turned the television on and I saw the pyres of smoke emanating from the buildings of Gaza. And I knew that underneath those pyres of smoke, there were innocent children, women, mothers, fathers, ordinary civilians who are stuck in Gaza. 1.5 million ordinary civilians who are stuck in Gaza. The clock is ticking. In 24 hours, it's very likely that the Israeli government will order their troops to enter Gaza. Can you imagine what that will be? This is why I am here today. There are no winners. There are only losers when it comes to death, when it comes to innocent civilians. There are no sides. We call on the ministers of all nations to please take responsibility. Speak out, demand an immediate and absolute ceasefire now. The resolution to peace is by negotiation. Otherwise, blood will be spilled. And I, as a mother, as a human being, as a humanitarian, dread to think what kind of images we are going to see from now on if Israel enter into Gaza. Thank you.
I am here today to speak on behalf of the 1.5 million people who are living in a state of terror in the Gaza Strip. And I imagine that you are here for the same reason. And on their behalf, I would like to urge the international community, in particularly President-elect Barack Obama, President Sarkozy, who hold the EU presidency, and Prime Minister Brown to stop the bloodshed and call for an immediate halt of the indiscriminate and disproportionate and unlawful Israeli bombardment against the Palestinian civilian population in Gaza.
For many, many years, the West has tried to dominate and control the Middle East. Egypt was occupied by Britain for nearly 100 years. Britain was in Palestine. The French were in Syria. We invaded Afghanistan in 1839. And let us be clear, what is happening now is that America is using Israel as its instrument for the control of the whole Middle East. That is the long-term issue. And when we say stop the war against the people of Palestine in Gaza, It is a part of the Stop the War campaign against the wars in Afghanistan and Iraq and the threat to Iran, and that is why we're here. So we are to mobilize world opinion, not just for peace for the people in Gaza, but for the rights of a free Palestine and for an end of Western domination in the Middle East. Good luck. Thank you very much.
What we're seeing now in Gaza is an experiment in provocation conducted by the Israeli government. You take 1.5 million people, you stuff them into a small space, you deny them food, water, sanitation, medicine, and then you act surprised when they get hostile.
And the cynical hypocrisy of Foreign Minister of Israel Livni saying, we telephone people and text them before we destroy their homes in order to save lives. What cynical hypocrisy is that? The people of Gaza have nowhere to run. They have suffered imprisonment. They have suffered poverty. They've suffered unemployment. They've suffered the shortages of food, of medicines, of energy, of all the things that they need to sustain life.
Israel, we send you a message from the capital of the UK. The Palestinian people will never kneel down. We will never accept these atrocious crimes. The Palestinians will never be crushed. Our resistance will continue until we gain our independence. We tell the international community not to let these atrocious crimes committed against our innocent people. It's a shame in the honor of humanity to let these war criminals who advocate democracy and committed heinous crimes against the innocent Palestinians. We tell the international community, we don't want your sympathy. We don't want your money. We want our freedom. We want our independence.
They hoped with their siege for 2 years they would have brought Gaza to its knees, but it is still standing. And this is why they are hysterical. This is why they are attacking schools and mosques and universities. They want us to believe it is Hamas. It is not Hamas. We know it is not the rockets. They have killed 430 in the West Bank in the last year. Not a single rocket from the West Bank. How do you explain this? But we understand this is the price. This is the price of freedom. This is the price for your resistance. This is the price for supporting your legitimate government. This is why they are attacking you. And we understand that this will end when the people of Gaza ensures that this criminal onslaught on them is ended sooner rather than later.
These malicious crimes and massacres have been occurring for way longer than 8 days now. They have been occurring for 60 years! 60 years! Of the state of Israel. Take a look at the massacres of Sabra and Shatila, killing 3,200 people. Take a look at the massacre of Deir Yassin, wiping out an entire village of its inhabitants. I, myself, am a Palestinian, and it gives me great pride to belong to such a nation. A nation... A nation who will not surrender. A nation who will stand firm for their grounds. A nation who will stand up and hold the roots of their fathers and forefathers. I am also proud to be British, but I am ashamed. Ashamed and appalled at the lack of action taken by our government.
Free Palestine! Free Palestine!